Hey, what's going on, guys and girls? My name is Epic9305. Welcome back to another Call of Duty video, and what we are going to be talking about today is, not sure how to put this, but, like, where Call of Duty Ghosts failed, where other Call of Duty succeeded. And I think Call of Duty Ghosts, in my opinion, personally, this is not to be reflected off of anyone else, but to me, personally, I did not care for the game that much, and I really wanted my $60 back after about 2 weeks of playing the game, but unfortunately, the people at GameStop are like, oh, okay, we'll give you $7. For your $60 game, we'll give you $7. So it's like, yeah, I'll just keep it and yell at it. So, I still have Call of Duty, and that's why you're watching this gameplay. So anyways, what I wanted to, like, really discuss and get into is how Ghosts failed at some aspects. Now, granted, this video is going to be kind of opinion-based, and the opinions from me, they're coming from me who I've really been into the Call of Duty franchise since it got big. I played since late Call of Duty 3. Now, granted, I didn't play a lot of Call of Duty 3, and I really started playing a lot of COD back in when Call of Duty 4 got some attention, and I was really into it. I already own Call of Duty 4, but I really got into it when it started getting some attention. So I feel like I've played through most of the Call of Duty franchise, and I kind of feel like I have the right to say what I believe a good Call of Duty game is, and to be honest, I don't feel like Ghosts is a good Call of Duty game. It just doesn't feel too much like Call of Duty, in my opinion. And I think part of the reason I and so many other people have been disappointed with this is because it was overhyped for one of the reasons. Now, I'm going to give you an instance. When they had really, really, like, over-exaggerated the capabilities of the dog in multiplayer. Granted, Riley is just the cutest little thing in campaign. He is an awesome puppy dog, and that dog is just amazing. He's a great dog, and they gotta spot him. However, in multiplayer, he makes no freaking sense. Okay, this dog touches you, and you magically die. Now, yes, I know Call of Duty's not famous for its animations. However, they could have put a little bit more effort into that. Into that animation, it's just like, jump on guy, grrr, and then he dies magically. That makes no type of sense. And on top of that, it's ridiculously OP in close quarters engagements. Because you're like, oh, just beat this guy in close quarter engagement, one kill away from a kill. Oh, he had a guard dog, never mind. That's literally, like, what's going to go through your mind when you kill someone who has one of those dogs and you're close to a high kill streak. It's just like, oh, shit. And then now, granted, whenever someone kills my guard dog, I get incredibly pissed off. Because I'm like, why would you kill an animal, and I go chase them around, even though the objective of Call of Duty is to kill people. So, that, just the overhyped aspects. And the campaign, Call of Duty campaigns, they're not really, they're nothing that, look at that kill, that is ridiculous, I knifed him in the face. But Call of Duty campaigns, are like, they've never been the main attraction, it's always been the multiplayer. However, I feel like Ghost's campaign kind of, like, set the bar to a new low, because I did not care for it that much. I mean, luckily I'll give them points for it not being a typical Russian invasion or America war with Russia like we've seen in the past 20-something Call of Duties. But it still was, like, typical America under attack. I mean, why can't it be, like, Ecuador under attack, and we defend Ecuador, huh? Oh, no, it has to be America every time. I mean, seriously. And, It just copied the Call of Duty invasion formula that's been around for a while. And to be honest, though, I wasn't really expecting anything else. It's just hard not to be like, oh man, when I played the Call of Duty campaign for Ghosts. However, the thing that really upset me the most was the multiplayer, and just how they changed the maps around. Now, the maps are much, much bigger than they've been in any Call of Duty, and you see, what most games would do to counter that is they'd say, add more players to each server. However, Call of Duty did not do that. It's still the same amount of players for every server. Now, you might be saying, oh, well, if you have Next Gen, it's got Ground War. Yes, but I was on Ground War yesterday. There were 16 people in the playlist. All right? I'm pretty sure the max is 18. There were 16 people. I waited 8 minutes to get into a game which did not even start because there were only two other players besides myself, okay? That is not something to be proud of, Call of Duty. That is definitely not something to be proud of. And what I feel like they tried to do was something that Black Ops 1 did, but Black Ops 1 did it a bit more successful. Now, when Black Ops 1 first came out, they came out and said something along the lines like, we want to give every player 3 seconds of lifetime after they spawn, which pissed the community off royally. However, I feel like Black Ops 1 pulled it off. Ghosts, they did the same thing, they just didn't say it in my eyes, and they wanted to give players like 20 minutes of survival time after the spawn. I don't know why, but what they've done is they expanded the spawn so they're further apart. Maybe this was to prevent spawn trapping, I don't know, it still happens anyway, so even if it was, I don't feel like it worked. But they said, let's spread the spawns out across the map, and let's make the map twice as big as our biggest maps, and then we'll see how it works. And granted, the game's graphics and the maps look cool, but they're just not really, in my opinion, they're not fun to play on. I mean, a lot of my friends that I played Black Ops 2 with and MW3, I've had some friends, I still have friends that I play with on Xbox One and PS4 that I've had since late MW2, which is really hilarious. And we've like kind of all said, this is so different, because when I hop on MW2, it's got the, or any Call of Duty for that matter, besides Ghosts, it's got the typical three-lane maps, which has been like a Call of Duty staple on the maps, which has been really cool. However, Ghosts, there's like 5 lanes. I remember it was on Prison Break, and there's like 5 different lanes for engagement to get to the enemy spawn. So essentially, all you need is one player not to go down one lane, and you've got a completely open entrance to the enemy's spawn. So it's kind of difficult to defend all of these places, especially in Domination, which I used to play a whole lot. If you watched my Black Ops 2 commentaries, I'm pretty sure the majority of them were on Domination or Kill Confirmed. However, I don't play a lot of Dom anymore because of that purpose. Just there's so many lanes that you have to protect that it's just not possible anymore. And I've lost interest in that. And granted, they may have been trying to attract a new audience or mimic MW2's success. Like, MW2 had a bit of a defensive style of gameplay made. However, with the 5 lanes, it's kind of a lot more difficult to try and play defensive, and it's a lot easier to play campy, which I really don't have anything against campers. I mean, seriously, if you're in a war zone, you're not going to be running around trying to shoot bad guys while, like, turning around in a circle and firing one bullet from the hip with, like, a 50 cal. But still, I mean, it's just, I don't have much against them, but it's just easier to do it in this game. And it's kind of brought a lot less weapon balance into the Call of Duty formula, I feel personally. Like, the M-Matar, the Remington, those are things that I feel are used a lot. And, well, of course, the Honey Badger, and maybe the FP9, which is what I'm actually using right now, because I love the gun to death, because it's so overpowered. But it feels like they've kind of limited the diversity a bit, which that's okay. They kind of did that in Black Ops 2, however, I do feel like it worked. Like, the MSMC and the PDW were really big in Black Ops 2. However, in games like, for instance, MW2 or Black Ops 1, there's a bit more diversity that I feel could have been used in Ghosts, which would have made the game a bit more fun. But I don't know, maybe I'm stupid or something. So anyways, guys, my name is TheEpicNate315. If you enjoyed this commentary, I would really, really, really like it if you would look at my previous videos. I would feel very, very good and warm inside. Anyways, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please, 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 please leave a comment in the comment section below. I loved. Anyways, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please, 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 please leave a comment in the comment section below. I love reading those, and it feels nice to know that people take the time out of their long days to leave a tiny message. So I'd appreciate it if you do that. Have a good night.